In iOS 17, Apple has taken SF Symbols 5 to the next level. With the new symbol effects and transitions, animated icons are here to stay. You can bounce, pulse, use variable colors, scale, appear, disappear, and replace. So much animations to choose from. So today, let's take a look at the gorgeous new way you can add SF symbols into your app in Xcode 15. Make sure to check out the link in the description for the summer sale, where you can have 70% off on all of my 14 products. Go ahead, check out the link in the description. Today, we are going to talk about SF Symbols 5 and the great new improvements in animation. And oh boy, they are so great. Just take a look at this GIF right over here. It's amazing. We have bounce, pulse, variable color, scale, appear, disappear, and replace. It's amazing. And we are going to cover it all today, how to do it in Xcode 15 beta for now. So what we are going to do is just open up an Xcode 15 beta project. Currently I have beta 2, but make sure that it's at least Xcode 15 beta 1. So we want to create a new Xcode project over here. Let me just resize this real quick. And I'm going to go with the iOS project and then product name. And of course, interface Swift UI, language Swift, because it's a Swift UI channel, so I really like that. Let's just drop this onto our desktop, why not? Let's create it right over here. And we are going to be presented with just a simple default demo application. So what we are going to use is the new SF symbols. By the way, make sure to check out also the link in the description for the download link for SF symbols. It's from Apple, and you can take a look at these new SF symbols inside the SF Symbols 5 beta app for now. Okay. So there we go, we have our hello world right over here. What I'm going to do is just make this a little bit larger so we can see it a little bit better. Okay, so we are going to create a lot of these images, so I'm going to put this inside a list. There we go, we have a list right over here. And first thing, I'm going to create a Wi-Fi router. So let's have an image right over here with system name, of course, and Wi-Fi.router. Okay, and there it is. Let me just take it over there. Let's just scroll a little bit. So we have our Wi-Fi router. Nothing new from now. But by the way, where can you find all of these system names? Well, you could just take a look at it inside the SF Symbol 5 app, or you could just go click on this plus button, open up the library and select SF Symbols right over here and just search for whatever you'd like. And then double click on it or hit return, and it will just insert it into your editor right over there. Great. So Wi-Fi router, it's just a simple system image named, a system named image. Okay, so now we have a new thing called system effect, symbol effect. So symbol, a new view modifier, symbol effect. And we are going to start off with just the simple one. So just a symbol effect dot. And let's just go with variable color and iterative, maybe. Let's just go with that. Okay, as you can see now, it's just, you know, animation for free with just a single line of code. Now, maybe we want this to be reversing. So reversing, there we go. Is just going reversing. It's so amazing that it was just a few, dot notations, variable color, iterative, reversing. That's a symbol effect. We have this nice animation. Also, you can just stack up your symbol effects. So symbol effect. Not the one with the value. We are going to talk about the one with the value, but for now, let's just go with scale.up. As you can see, it just scaled up and it stayed there. And now we have a variable color iterative reversing animation, symbol effect. Okay, that's kind of the warm-up right over here. Introducing Summer Sale, my exclusive product bundle, the ultimate solution to supercharge your Swift UI projects. For a limited time only, you can save a whopping 70% when you grab this incredible bundle, packed with 14 top-notch products, including the game-changing navigation router, revenue-boosting StoreKit Pro, and engaging R message. This bundle is designed to elevate your SwiftUI projects to new heights. Don't miss out on this exceptional opportunity to unlock advanced features, enhance user engagement, and simplify your SwiftUI work. Act now and secure your bundle before the offer expires. The link is in the description. Now, what I want to do is whenever, you know, I want to control this animation. So whenever I switch on a toggle, I want this to be turned on or off. So let's create a horizontal stack right over here. And I'm going to add my toggle first. So let's have a toggle. And for that, I'm going to need a state variable. So let's just name this. Default is false. Okay, so we are not connected to the internet, that's fine. So for the toggle, I'm going to go with the title and is on. The title, well, according to the is connected to the internet, we are going to say this is connected with a capital C. Otherwise, this should be searching. Okay. So the binding $ is connected to internet. Okay, so we have that toggle right over there, searching. Currently it's searching. Okay, that's fine. But now I want to, well, let me just copy out that Wi-Fi router over there, putting it over there. I'm going to use the symbol effect with the is active. So dot symbol effect and effect with a value. So let's see, is active right over here. And cool thing with Xcode 15, now if I hit on the right arrow, I can choose between those options. And let me just choose effect is active. Now the effect will be variable color dot iterative dot reversing. Now for the is active, I'm going to say is connected to the internet. So now, as you can see, it is, well, maybe, there we go. It has to be the other way around. So I'm just going to put an exclamation mark over there. Okay, it is connected. And if I want to search for it, as you can see, it's searching and now it's searching. Now it is connected. It's really, really cool. This is how you can have and is active on your symbol effect. Okay, that's for doing one animation, but this could be repeated a certain amount of times. So let me just add another right over here. So this time around, I'm going to add a button that will bounce, repeat two times the bounce. So again, a horizontal stack, because I want to add that button right over there, the button with the title. The title, well, let's just have a little bit space over here, bounce. And the action, well, we want to have a bounce value. So for the bounce value, I'm going to create a new state variable. Bounce value equals false. Now, it doesn't really matter if this is true or false. What matters is that this state variable changes its value. So we are going to say bounce value dot toggle. Okay, so we have our button right over here. What we want to actually do is just bounce an image, a system image named, and I'm going to copy out from my notes right over here because this is a really long one. So it is antenna, radio waves, left and right. Okay, so I want to bounce this two times whenever I tap on the bounce button. So we are going to say symbol effect And we are going to use the one with the options and value. There we go. Effect dot bounce. If we just left it where it just bounced, it's just going to bounce once. But for the options, I'm going to say repeat count two. And the value, you know, when we are going to trigger this bounce that is going to be repeated twice, it's going to be our bounce value. Okay, so there we go. Let's just see it. Clicking on it, as you can see, it's just nicely bounced twice. Let's just click on it again. There we go. Really, really nice. Okay, now next up is a really, really fun one when we are going to transition from one SF symbol to another SF symbol. So really common use case is the play and pause button. So let's just create that button right over here with an action and a label. For the action, I'm going to say, well, let's just have a state variable again. I'm going to duplicate this and say that is paused. And by default, this should be false. Okay. And then on the action, I'm going to say is paused. Again, I'm going to toggle between the play and pause button. So right over here on the label, I'm going to create an image. System image, where is the auto completion? There we go, system name. And if is paused, come on, is paused, there we go, auto completion. I'm going to say this is pause.fail. Otherwise, this is play.fail. Okay. So currently, because this the pause is set to false, then the play.fail will be presented. And now we want to have a content transition. So content transition. And this transition will be a symbol effect. And let's just have a simple effect. You can have also options as you saw previously. For now, let's just have dot replace. And how are we going to replace it? Well, in my case, it's off, up. So it's going to go off, up. Okay, so let's just click on here. There we go. I don't know if you can just see this really nicely. Go ahead and follow along the tutorial in your project. You will see this nice transition between those two SF symbols. It's really, really amazing. Okay, next up is showing and hiding SF symbols. So I'm going to create here two shapes, and I'm going to put an SF symbol between them so we can make sure that you see whenever it's going to disappear and whenever it's also going to disappear and not leave any space between those two shapes. So let me just build out real quickly that view. So a horizontal stack, and I want to have a button right over there with a title and action. Now the title, I'm going to hide a moon. So let's just see, we should have a state variable of isMoonHidden. So let's just duplicate this command D, by the way. So is moon hidden. Okay. And then for the button, I'm going to have is moon hidden. Of course, question mark. This should be, let me just think about it. Show and then hide. Yes. Okay. And then for the action, I want to have a with animation and is moon hidden dot toggle. So we're going to show and hide our moon, but of course we don't have any moon just yet. So I'm going to add another horizontal stack right over here. And let's have a rounded rectangle with a corner radius of 5. And then I'm going to have a frame on it with a width of 20 and a height of 20. And then the foreground color of gray. Okay, so we have that over there. I'm going to copy this out and paste it one more time. And instead of the rounded rectangle, I'm going to have just a simple circle, just like that. Okay, so now it's time to add in between those two our SF symbol. So let's just have a simple image of system named. Come on, system named. And let's just go with a moon. Oh, moon dot stars. Okay, so we have that moon dot stars right over there. So whenever I click on hide right over here, I just want to hide that image. So one approach, and this is our first one, is to just go if it's not hidden. So if is a moon not hidden, there we go, with an exclamation mark, then we are going to show it right over there. So because now we can just do it just like that. It's really, really nice. We kind of already know this, but it's much more simpler now with the transition, and we are going to add a symbol effect and dot disappear and how down. Now let's take a look at it again. It's really, really nice. Much, much nicer. I don't know, maybe take a look at the video, rewind, and take a look at the changes right over here. So this is really, really nice already, but there's even a nicer way of doing this. So currently it's just hiding it. It's just removing it from the view hierarchy. Sometimes you don't want to do that. So what we are going to do is, first of all, I'm going to copy out the image, paste it in there, and then add a symbol effect. And I'm going to choose the one with the is active again. Let's just go effect and then dot disappear. And the effect is moon hidden. Okay, so I'm just going to refactor this and rename it to a capital M. Really nice. Okay, so let's see the preview now. And now if I click on hide, as you can see now, it really, really shines that this symbol effect is indeed disappearing. It's really, really nice. Now, if you did like this new video on the new SF Symbol 5, make sure to check out how to handle data in Swift UI 5. The video is right over here.